with the amazing block. Has the duck so he doesn't hit his head on the backboard. That's how high he gets.
I mean, he was filling up the stat sheet, obviously, on the offensive end. But in this game, once again, three blocks, three steals. He did have one bad defensive play late on a critical possession. But his ability to come from the weak side and help defense is outstanding.
All right, Spurs and Kings, Rudy Gay with the big slam. Rudy.
Yeah, Rudy's one of my favorite players. I love the way, great fit in San Antonio. Who you like, Nick, that first round? San Antonio, who you like them facing, bro?
It's going to be tough. I think they're going to be the seventh seed.
Okay.
I think it's going to be San Antonio, Denver. That's my guess. This was wild.
Yeah, Hawks and Bucks, and the Trae Young story makes the miraculous buzzer beater to top the Bucks in overtime.
Are all the Rookie of the Year votes in? Hey, people down.
They're not. I mean, they shouldn't be. You shouldn't cast your ballot until the 82nd game has been played.
In the last 30 days, Trae is making a push.
Especially because the Mavs can't win. The Mavs are trying to lose to keep the pick from going to the Hawks. So they lost 12 of 13. It's interesting. Talk more about that maybe never.
Moving on. All right, so
on your radio show.
I found it
Vegas announced win totals for NFL teams next season, you know, because Vegas knows.
Oh, yeah.
The Cowboys were projected by the experts to win 8.5 games, second in the NFC East to the Eagles. This comes after the Cowboys surprised many by winning 10 games and the division last season. Keep in mind, still a number of players the Cowboys need and want to sign to extensions after a relatively quiet offseason. CeCe, how do the Cowboys take a step forward now this coming year?
I believe it has a lot to do with the offense. I like the way that the young players on their defense have progressed. But can that offensive line, can they get back to a level where maybe they're a top five offensive line? But I believe it all comes through their passing game and Dak Prescott. I know they've made some additions to the coaching staff. Kellen Moore, he's taken over and being the offensive coordinator. John Kitna is the quarterback coach. So I just believe last year, Sanjay Lau took over. And in conversating with him, they were going to concentrate on the deep passing game. So I look for Dallas. Are there 4 to 6 games during the season where their passing attack can win them games? We know typically if you break down a game, that being September or December, Jenna's like, Chris, what are the keys to the game? Hey, Jenna, they got to run the ball. Zeke's got to have a great day. But I just believe this year for the Dallas Cowboys, if they're going to make that jump to where they are, because I believe they're going to have a pretty good defense. Their passing game has to be more consistent. In 4 to 6 games, Dak's got to be able to win the game. And that's because they've put a lot of people close to the box, or it's a couple of games where they throw for over 300 yards.
On an NCAA tournament Monday, I think this is a very apropos question, because how will Dallas improve? The same way a college basketball team improves from one year to the next without a big recruiting class. Your sophomores and juniors get better. The guys who were there last year get better. That is Dallas's method for next season. They're not going to have any five-star recruit coming in. They're not going to have any blue-chip McDonald's All-American that's going to be an infusion. Now, Randall Cobb is a nice addition and a bit of an upgrade, but it is about their young players, Zeke maintaining, Dak improving, Amari continuing where he was once he became a Dallas Cowboy, and those offensive linemen playing up to their salary levels. Like, I think the defense is going to be good, not a great dominant defense. I think if they feel like we're going to go into the season and win games the way Baltimore did, I think that's foolish. I don't think the defense is going to be that good, especially with the loss of Randy Gregory as one of their pass rushers. But, and I know they have those two young linebackers they like a lot, but I don't think this is a top three defense. I think the way the Cowboys can continue what they were in the last half of last season is by being what they were in the last half of last season, a well-balanced team. In the last 8 games of the year, Dak looked like the quarterback he was his rookie year. They had a legitimate passing attack, so they had a top-8 offense married with a top-8 defense. That's the Cowboys' method moving forward. Do what you did last year consistently for an entire season, not just in fits and spurts, because I don't think they can sustain a 6 to 8 game slump from Dak like they had to start last season, because I don't think Philly's going to be dealing with the quarterback injury and their fits and starts the way they did last year.
You mentioned Kellen Moore and John Kitna. Are you worried at all about the experience within that? I mean, forget Jason Garrett, just because he hasn't had such a heavy hand in calling plays the last couple years. Are you worried about the experience and the coaching staff on that offense?
I'm worried about the lack of play calling ability. They don't have someone on that staff that's called to play in an NFL game. And we know that Dallas, there's a lot of always noise in Dallas. It always gets hot at some point in the season. At some point in the season, it will be questioned, are these guys good enough to be Dallas Cowboys coach? You don't have any play calling experience. All these games come down in the fourth quarter. Can you make a play? Their coaching will be criticized an awful lot. And can they be able to stomach that? What's going on in Dallas? It happens every year. So Jason Garrett, I wouldn't be surprised if this year, if he leaned a little bit towards the offensive side from a staffing standpoint to be able to help them out, to be able to ease that burden. Because, yes, it's a legitimate question. I don't care if a guy, if you gave him the title and he doesn't have a resume, why wouldn't we question it? I don't know who Kellen Moore is going to be as an offensive coordinator. What's his philosophy?
Right.
What does he do when he if he's backed up? What does he do if he's a third down and short? Like, what's his theme? Well, which part of the team is he going to take advantage of? So I'll be listening to a lot of the sound bites that come out of Dallas, listening to interviews, because I really don't know, and I'm not going to guess. I know he's going to be under a lot of pressure, and that part, there will be a lot of eyes on offense coordinator and John Kitna, the new quarterback coach.
Given their restrictions salary cap-wise, because they seem so dead set on giving Dak a premature extension, along with they have to extend Amari, I think they will extend Zeke this offseason. They could wait until next offseason, and we know the situation with DeMarcus Lawrence. I like their offseason moves. I think Randall Cobb's a good move. Over the weekend, a little undercover move. They traded for Robert Quinn, a guy who could be a pass rusher opposite DeMarcus Lawrence, and they got him for a sixth-round pick to turn into a fifth-round pick. Very little compensation. George Iloka should help their safety group. So when you are bargain shopping, right. I think they've done a deep, for, by my eye, I think they've done a good job with that. So those guys, those players should help a bit, but it's going to be about Dallas, the Dallas Cowboys, who were there in 2018, being as good or better than they were that year in 2019.
You make a good point as far as some of those players they picked up. Because when we see teams like New England and the Rams, both of those teams from last year's Super Bowl, look at some of the veteran players that they were able to pick up. Ndamukong Suh on a one-year deal. We saw the New England got pass rush help. Mm-hmm. We saw they got the left tackle,
Trent Brown
to be able to shore up their passing duties on that. But also, let's not forget, you have to develop a couple players, not second or third. You have to go out and there have to be a couple guys on this roster right now we're not talking about that they become part of the story. And you have to depend on that coaching staff to be able to go out and find them. Defensive coaching staff, do you have someone who can create some turnovers? That being on the front end with those defensive line, which they got a couple spots available, or on the back end with that secondary that doesn't create a lot of interception. And if we're talking about them during the season, that's because that coaching staff has gotten these guys up to speed.
And on the offensive end, I think within that building, the guy they are hoping is the person Chris is talking about is Michael Gallup, the wide receiver they took in the third round last year, the wide receiver that adds an extra dimension of speed, that with having Amari there for a full year, Cobb is a legitimate guy in the slot, that Gallup can be a guy that emerges as a potential legitimate number two receiver in this league. On the defensive side, we know who the names are. We know Van Der Esch, we know Jalen Smith, we know Byron Jones. We already mentioned DeMarcus Lawrence. They added Christian Covington, the D tackle from the Houston Texans. Michael Gallup's the guy I would pinpoint on. If the Cowboys offense takes the next step, he will have to be a big part of it, because I don't think the tight end they brought out of retirement is going to be that guy.
All right. Cowboys hoping to play even better next year. You know who else is? The Lakers coming up. Does LeBron have any chance of turning things?